Discs from a wastewater treatment plant were first spotted yesterday on a beach in Seabrook. Today, thousands of them were discovered just a few miles away in Hampton. That's where we find Jennifer Gannon tonight. Jennifer.
Well, Korea, most of the people we spoke with today say they had no idea what those discs were scattered across the beach here, but when they found out what was potentially on them, they were disgusted.
You'd think that there would be signs or something saying not to pick them up.
The mild temperatures brought plenty of people out to Hampton Beach Saturday, but most had no idea there was something potentially dangerous washing ashore.
I saw a little disc, hundreds of them at the high water mark, and I thought, what the heck are these?
It turns out Stephen LaBranche spotted mesh discs from a wastewater treatment plant in Hooksett.
They didn't look clean, that's the thing. They looked as if they had been like a coffee filter that had been used.
An undisclosed number of the discs were sent into the Merrimack River after heavy rains caused tanks at the plant to overflow. And now those discs, which are used to harbor bacteria, are washing up the coast.
There are people with dogs. Dogs are going to go over and curious and look and see what they are. Little children are going to pick them up. And that, they're hazardous waste.
It's something that has parents concerned.
My little one loves to pick up the shells and the rocks and the driftwood.
Right now, the state is working out a cleanup effort and testing samples for bacteria levels. In the meantime, they're warning people not to touch the discs with their bare hands.
If they're picking them up, they should use rubber gloves, take precautions. We don't want children playing with these sorts of things because the potential exists that bacteria from the wastewater treatment process could still be on these discs.
Right now, we are still waiting for test results to find out what kind of bacteria we're dealing with on those discs. Now, officials say that the cold and salty water could help to reduce the risk. Reporting live in Hampton Beach, Jennifer Gannon, WMUR News 9.